says in the scripture, St. Paul tells us that always show respect and love for your spiritual leaders, for they will give account for our souls. So whether they do everything right or the way we would like to see them do things is of no consequence, just like for our parents. God doesn't say, honor your parents, your mother and your father, if they're good or if they're right or if they make all the right decisions. Honor your mother and your father, the Ten Commandments say. St. Paul reminds us, honor, respect, and love your spiritual leaders. And then what happens? When God sees our effort, each of us, to love and respect, or to try to love and respect each and every person, and the hierarchs, and our next door neighbor, and our own family, then he gives us inner peace and inner satisfaction that we're working out our salvation. You see, it doesn't depend on others. Everything is in our hands. Of course, we will get guidance here and there. We read things and so forth. But it's in our hands, as St. Paul tells us, to work out our salvation. Να δουλεύετε τον καθένα σας την σωτηρία σας. What a beautiful thing. I said to someone earlier, we don't have to worry. Like it says on the beautiful arch that we have here, entrance to a little section with a new chapel and Παναγία Ζωδόχοπηχή. Μηδέν μεριμνάτε, λέει ο Απόστολος στους Φιλιππίους. To the Philippians, St. Paul says, don't worry about anything. Just trust God. And this is the feeling that we want to cultivate, trusting in God. Someone might offend us. Someone might say something cruel. Someone might scandalize us. Someone might, who knows what it might be. But we have the privilege to trust, love, and respect God. What do the Proverbs say? Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. He will take care of you. So that becomes that very, very special personal relationship that each and every person should have if they want to with Christ. Some of the saints, these recent Gherondas, told us, don't deny yourself the privilege to be one with God. You have the privilege to do that. Do it. Each of us can do it. And we have to learn not to let worldly mindset come into play. So we can be one with God, each of us. When you stand by your bed in the night before you go to sleep, it's you and God. What a wonderful thing. We can shed a tear of repentance and say, I'm sorry that I acted this way or said this or did that, but I love you so much and I want to love you more. Please help me. Then we can do our stavro and go to sleep peacefully. If we just open our heart and say, I love you, Lord, forgive me. I'm trying, but I always make some mistakes. I want to be with you. And then, continuing, he will help us. Yes. A good reminder. Because sometimes we forget, we get lost in all the rubrics, fasting, prayers, go to church, don't go to church. I was going to say, the fathers say to us, don't deny yourself the privilege to be one with God. If you do, it's kind of your fault. Be one with him. Even if you're a homeless person, maybe a homeless person is listening to us tonight, I don't know. Be one with God. It reminds me of that movie I saw many years ago. It's one of my favorite movies. It may not be to yours, I don't know. It's called The Soloist. There was an actor, I forget his name. Anyway, it was about a homeless person who had reached the heights in Juilliard School of Music in New York somewhere, but he was schizophrenic. So he couldn't finish his studies, but he was a special violin player, I think, cello maybe. And he ended up as a homeless person. But one man overheard him playing his cello in the underground somewhere, under a bridge somewhere. And he saw him playing like Mozart there. And they became friends. It's a beautiful story of friendship. I really recommend you see it. If you want to see it before Pascha, it will give you very good feelings and understandings about respect and love. And that homeless person, Jamie Foxx was the actor's name, he would pray every night. He was living in a shelter or in his place there on the streets, raining sometimes, and he would say, "Be our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name." Τι ωραίο πράγμα. Τι ωραία προσευχή που μας έδωσε ο Θεός και δεν το λέμε. Every day we should say the Pater Noster with all of our heart. We wake up in the morning, we stretch. Our Father who art in heaven, Pater imon, o entis uranis, agiastito to onoma sou, may your name be so holy. I love you so much. May your name be holy. May your will be done. I want whatever you want to be done. That prayer, maybe it could be the only prayer we need to say. We have a lot of books, prayers and prayers and prayers and psalms. Οι Απόστολοι ρωτήσανε τον Χριστό μας, ποια είναι η καλύτερη προσευχή. What is the best prayer we can say, Lord? They were talking to Jesus himself. And he said, okay, I'll tell you. It goes like this. Πάτερ ημών, ο εν τοις ουρανοίς, αγιαστήτω το όνομά σου. Ελθέτω η βασίλεια σου, γεννηθήτω το θέλημά σου. Ως εν ουρανό και επί της γης. Τον άρτον ημών των επιούσιων, δώσει ημίν σήμερα. Και άφεση ημίν τα οφειλήματα ημών, ως και ημίς αφήμε. Can you imagine we have the key to be forgiven? All we have to do is to forgive others. What a beautiful key. A key to peace. A key to calm. A key to confidence and trust in God. Just forgive everybody, as Christ told us to forgive in the Pater Imon, the very foundational prayer of all of us. In fact, I'm going to try to do it myself. I would like to recommend tonight, as we begin Holy Week, yes, go to some of the services. If you can't go to watch online, when you hear the Pater Imon come up periodically through the services, stand with awe and attention and focus. The Pater Imon. There's one saint, we said it before, I don't remember his name, who every night all his life, maybe it was on Mount Athos or Patmos or Mount Sinai, I don't remember, he would say one Pater Imon from sunset to sunup. He could only finish one Pater Imon because it was so meaningful to him. He really glorified God. And one of the keys that the Fathers teach us about the Pater Imon is that we say Pater Imon, our Father. It makes us connected like we are tonight through the airwaves, through and the goodness of Kelly and Costa and Georgia and all of you. We are one. We say our Father. What a wonderful thing. Christ taught us that. Imagine our Savior, the one to whom we focus all things. We're having now Holy Week to walk through his passion with him, the sufferings that he endured for our sakes, crucifixion and the end, and his glorious resurrection. Τον ουράνιο πατέρα είπε, Ina osi en. He asked his Heavenly Father that they may all be one, as you and I, Father, are one. Ωραία. Αυτά. Αυτά είναι τα μνημήματα που θέλει να δώσει ο Χριστός, ο Θεός, σε εμάς όλους τους χριστιανούς. Not to be at unrest. There are a lot of things happening in the world. I know we have this problem with what they call the pandemic, using a beautiful Greek word, pandemia, the COVID flu or whatever that is, and action. All right, what can we do? There are a lot of things that are happening in the world. There have also been other sicknesses, and there are other sicknesses still. We hardly hear any more about the people who are suffering from leukemia. I had a brother priest just called me yesterday. Please pray for me and ask anyone you know to pray for me. I have leukemia. He's 66 years old. How old is he? You can pray for him too, Father Nicholas. Pater Nicholas. Pray for him. Maybe God will help him in this. Maybe it's another trial for this priest to make him an even better priest. All right? And he's accepting it that way. Whatever comes in this world, whatever comes, we love God and we respect God, so zero problems. Miden problema. Όλα είναι καλά στα χέρια του Θεού. Like my Gheronda once told me recently, άφησε τη βάρκα στην θάλασσα να τρέχει και για την ψυχή σου άφησε τα όλα στα χέρια του Θεού. We call ourselves Orthodox Christians και Έλληνες. What do we mean by this? We mean that we care, as Christ does, for all the world. We care. It hurts us that there is suffering. It hurts us that there is sickness. It hurts us that there is crime. It hurts us that there are crazy things going on. And so we pray with a big ψυχή, μεγάλη ψυχή, για όλο τον κόσμο, όλοι να είναι καλά. We're not just worried about ourselves. We don't just go to church in my little bubble to say, me. Oh, για όλο τον κόσμο. And that's how we become really united and with each other as the church, but also more so with the whole world. And then everybody becomes our brother and our sister and our friend. We can walk with ease on the street. Hello. Good evening. And our hearts are filled because we know we walk with God and that that is our brother, that this is another person who was made in the image and likeness of God. When we cultivate throughout our short lives these kinds of feelings, then we're all right. Short life. We had today a dear person in our realm here, 71 years old, went to the heavens. But all right, 71 years. It says we read it every morning in the Psalms. I think it's Psalm 22. The span of a man's life is 70. That's 70. 20, 20, 20, 60 plus 10. Some 80, but more than this is trial and travail. Η ζωή μας είναι 60 και 10, ορισμένη μέχρι 80, αλλά πάνω από 80 είναι δύσκολο. Οπότε, we can all say to ourselves, all right, how old am I? If I live the average age between 70 and 80, what can I do with these few years that I have left to really exercise and show my love for God and for my fellow man? So Christos αγκάλιασε όλα τα παιδάκια, saying, let the children come unto me. To such belongs the kingdom of God. They have an innocence and a purity. Μια αθωότητα και αγνότητα που λίγο πολύ όλοι έχουμε χάσει. Γι' αυτό we want to see the children always, to remember how we can truly be. We don't have to have so much, you know, know-how and cleverness about ourselves. Let us be pure and innocent like children. Saint Apollonius, he says, when we speak to God, when we pray to God, we should pray like a little child, actually, of course, praying to our Heavenly Father, and know with confidence that He gives us what's best for us. Reading the Bible is very beautiful. Saint John Chrysostom always was inspiring people to read the Word of God. We should, and now it's so easy, you know, just pick it up, you have it, you can read it. A lady was here last night, God bless her, Eleni. She said, you know what I love to do? Yeah, I don't know. She said, I pick up the Bible and I just open it and I read, the Lord hear you in the day of trouble. What a beautiful thing. God hears us. So read your Bible. To different people who come to me for confession or guidance, I say different things. One thing I like to advise a lot of people to do is to read the epistles of St. Paul. So beautiful. Start from Romans, go next to what's next, Corinthians, and read. And you have your own personal spiritual trainer right in your own home. But you don't have to, but if we can, a little bit. Each in his own way. But have our Bible in the house. It's good to have our Bible and to keep it open. Keep it open, and once in a while, look and read a word, even one word. Gheronda Father Simeon Krayopoulos told us that when I was studying in Thessaloniki 40 years ago. He said, keep the Bible open, and even if you read one word a day from the Bible, it's huge, of course. That's the Word of God. But I love it. We have to know God. Christ didn't come here into the earth to give us a Bible. He came to give us Himself. And you can love God without a Bible if you try to and if you mean it. Στη γιορτή της Υπαπαντής του Χριστού, λέμε μια πολύ ωραία, ένα πολύ ωραίο ύμνο, which I like to say throughout the whole year. There's a hymn that we sing in the Υπαπαντή, or the presentation, the meeting of our Savior on his 40th day when Παναγία took him to the church. Θεωτό και η ελπής πάντων των χριστιανών. Σκέπε φρούρι φύλατε, τους ελπίζοντας είσαι. Θεοτόκος, you are the hope of the Christian family. Shelter, safeguard, and protect us who place our trust in thee. Με αυτό ίσως να τελειώνουμε. Έχουμε ως μητέρα όλου του κόσμου την Παναγία Μητέρα του Χριστού. And that's not a small thing. In fact, it's of the biggest things. And therein we learn about respect and love, because of the respect and love that she had before she even gave birth to our Savior. And that's why she was selected, of course, to be his mother. She had the highest level of respect and love for God. And she was counted worthy to hear from the archangel that she could be the mother of God if she would thus choose. And she said, Yenitomi, kata to rima sou. Let it be done to me according to your word. And she became, at that instant, the mother of God. He was conceived in her womb by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit. And so we place our trusts in her. We learn to honor our mother and father as learning to love and honor the mother of Christ and his father, our heavenly father. So let that be a nice ending note for us. We have God, the Holy Trinity, to learn to love him more and to ask the grace and the inspiration of his mother, whom we also devote our love to, as we try to learn and love each other. Παναγία να είναι μαζί όλους σας. Εύχομαι φέτος η μεγάλη εβδομάδα. Πρώτη φορά που θα την δούμε, έστω και να μην είμαστε στις εκκλησίες, αλλά να θυμηθούμε κάθε μέρα και με τα βιβλία μας στα σπίτια μας και στο βίντεο να δούμε τις ακολουθίες. Και να θέλουμε και να μας βοηθήσει ο Θεός και θα μας βοηθήσει να τον αγαπάμε πιο περισσότερο.